And oh, good morning. Welcome to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. Another bright sunny day in the United Kingdom. And this is a quick look at sensors. Primarily to help you make an auto door. Now these are actually fairly simple to do. First of all, you need a door. I've already built one. I like these doors. These are my favourite. And we need a sensor. Now you can find sensors on your build menu near or with the same group as remote control blocks. I've got one here already. Now, sensors have to be placed in a particular way. If you look at the icon of the sensor, you will see that there is a bar at the bottom. As long as that bar is at the bottom, your sensor is correctly orientated. So let's pop one in. Right. Now, I always suggest interacting with the control panel of the sliding door. And say you're making an airlock, rename it airlock. Just so, if you've got a big grid with lots of sliding doors on it, you know exactly what you're looking at. So now we've got that, we need to set up the sensor. Now what you need to do is look at the sensor. You don't need to fly up until you see the control panel controls. Holding down both bumpers and the inventory button will open the control panel of the sensor. You'll see the sensor. So first thing you want to do is make sure you've got your field set up. This is the actual field that the sensor detects in. As you can see, this one has left, right, bottom, top, back and front. Now we're only concerned with the bottom, the back and the front for our door. So bring all these down, holding down the left bumper will move it quicker. If you hold down both bumpers while selecting this, you can just press left and it will go straight down. Now we want to bring the back to about 2 meters, say. Doesn't have to be 2 meters, it can be a little, there we go. And the front, say about 1 meter. It's really easy to set this up. The bottom's okay, the top is now okay, and we're going to leave it on audible. And it's to detect players. And you can have sensors detect all sorts of things. As I'm scrolling down, you'll see detecting the owner, detecting friendly, detecting neutral, enemy. So, now we want to set up the actions. Now, sensors have two actions. They have one that triggers when the sensor field is entered and one that triggers when the sensor field is exited. So what you want is you want airlock, and then on entering the sensor field, open, and on exiting the sensor field, closed. And then, now, when we move towards the door, it opens. When we walk out of the sensor field, it closes. Same deal, open, close. And that is your very basic sensor door. And that's all there is to it. You can use sensors for other things. You have to experiment with it. There are ways of using sensors to make drill rigs go down by half a meter at a time. There are ways to use more than one sensor to create an airlock using these doors here when placed together. These doors are really good at making a simple airlock. For instance, if we just do this, you have a simple airlock. You can create it so that both doors are automatic. You just need to put another sensor on this side. But that's it. That is your quick introduction on sensors. Remember the rule. The bar at the bottom, facing down, and your sensor field will project correctly. And that's it. Stay safe. Take care. Have fun. Happy engineering. Until the next one. Bye-bye.